Them That Follow is a Sundance movie that finally hit theaters, and it stars Olivia Colman, Walter Goggins, Caitlin Dever, Lewis Pullman, Alice Engler, Thomas Mann, and it's a movie about a pastor's daughter who holds a secret that threatens to tear her community apart. Now, going into this movie, knowing that simple premise as well as the cast, and that's a Sundance movie, I was game. I was very much so excited for this movie, especially since Sundance was about 6-7 months ago, so I've been anticipating this movie since then. Not like really, really anticipating, because I only vaguely knew about it. But once I actually saw the trailer, I was just like, yes, this is going to be very interesting. And it doesn't fail. It's actually a very interesting movie. I think that what's especially interesting is that I feel like if someone kind of stumbles upon this movie in theaters or even on DVD or Blu-ray, they're going to think to themselves, this isn't actually something that happens still in 2019. And unfortunately, it's something that does. I think it's very ignorant to think that stuff like this doesn't still happen. It does. It's 2019, but everyone's environment is different. And I think that's the interesting thing about this movie, is that it really does focus on environment and how things are so different depending on point of views, and how really if everyone is the same, it does get pretty bland and boring. And at the same time, there just is a lot of toxic things that go on. And I think that this movie does a really good depiction of religious extremism, especially since someone that can kind of relate, not going to get really too into that, but I can kind of relate to that, especially with my upbringing and everything. And I think that's why I was especially able to latch on to this story and say, yes, this is realistic. Like, this is something that does still occur. And I liked that. I also think the execution was very organic. I mean, the movie does take its time. It's only 98 minutes, but it does take its time with stretching everything out, and so you can really get to know these characters, the motivations. And even if some of them might feel a bit one note, it's still very effective. Like, Walter Goggins' character doesn't have a lot of range, but he's still great in it. Like, I never would have thought he'd be a great pastor, but he is. He was a great pastor. I was like, oh, wow, you are really good, man. You're not just someone that can be in Tarantino movies. Don't bring it to this religious movie. And I also think that this movie does a really good job of focusing a lot. Like, it has a lot on its mind. Not only just religious extremism, but toxic masculinity, sexism. Sexism gets a lot of focus. Female empowerment or the lack thereof in this community. It's just a lot of stuff that I really dug that they focused on. And I get it, it's 2019, some movies are focusing on that now. And I'm all for that, I'm glad. But I feel like this movie did it in such a way that really, really worked. And you'll know what I'm talking about when you get to that final scene. Because that final scene was so, I don't want to say uplifting, but it was just so effective at saying, yes, yes. Especially after 90 minutes of dealing with everything else I just said. So the acting's great. The messages, I think, are really effective, at least for me personally. It's well shot. It has that indie kind of feel where it's like, you know, shaky camera work. But it works, especially with what it's going for with this environment, everything. Especially since it's almost like a representation of the main character and all the things she's going through. Because she's going through wanting what her family wants versus what she might want. Just it's suppressed. Suppression is also something that, by the way, gets focused on in this movie. There really is a lot that's going on in this movie. It's 90 minutes of stuffing a bunch of messages that, for me personally, worked. So it gets props on all of those categories. I also think that it's such a good movie to watch with someone, because after watching this movie, you can just talk about it and just break it down. And I think those are the best type of movies. It's not a perfect movie by any means, but it is an effective movie. For one, I'd say in terms of negatives, I do think that as much as I enjoy that this movie took its time with the pacing, I do think that it was also problematic, because there were some instances where I did think that the glacial pacing really did take me out of the movie. And it's a shame, because, again, I think that this is an effective movie on many regards. I also kind of wish that, as well-developed as these characters were, I do wish that there were a little bit more scenes with certain characters so that we kind of understood where they were coming from a little bit more, just a little bit. Again, it's just nitpicks at this point. I don't think it's a perfect movie for those regards, as well as I do think that it's a 98-minute movie, but it does feel a lot longer. Not even kidding about that. But who knows? Maybe upon rewatching, I'll like it more. But that's the thing also. I think that as much as I got a lot out from Them That Follow, I don't see myself wanting to rewatch this multiple times. That's just me personally, and maybe I'll change my mind, because I do feel like the more I'm thinking about this movie, the more I'm liking it more and more. But overall, Them That Follow, I'll definitely recommend it. It's a very well-acted movie. It's got a lot of interesting messages. It's like The Village meets Handmaid's Tale in a very organic and natural feeling way. And I would say, a couple flaws aside, definitely watch Them That Follow. And I'll be giving it personally a 3.5 to 5 star rating, which is like a hot sauce rating. It's the good old Texas Pete hot sauce rating. So there you have it, guys. Them That Follow, Sundance movie that finally reached theaters near us. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. How did you like this movie? Were you able to relate to it? Were you able to see where these characters were coming from and just all the different perspectives? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. And any stories about, you know, if you're able to relate with the religious extremism that's depicted on screen, comment section down below. And as always, guys, thank you very much for watching. Don't forget the subscription, notification bell, and I'll catch you guys later.